our spinning mule. Have you ever heard of a mule in the animal kingdom? Do you know what it is? Any ideas?
No.
You haven't seen one? Sorry if you haven't.
A donkey!
Excellent! Yeah, it's a mix of a donkey and a horse. It's what we call a hybrid. It's two different animals squished together. And just like that, this one's a bit of a hybrid, a bit of a mixture. It's two older machines, the spinning jenny and the water frame, and they come together into this fantastic piece of machinery. So on the back here, we've got all of that roving, that last stuff we just made in our speed frames. It gets connected here to this carriage on the front, and it gets connected on a little metal point. We call that a spindle. So when the machine gets turned on, this carriage here starts to roll forwards. And as it does that, all the roving starts kind of jumping about because it's slipping off the end of this little spindle. Once it comes all the way to the front, it goes rushing back towards this end of the machine. As it does that, the spindle turns and we make a bobbin of this stuff. We make our thread. Now I find that really weird to think about, especially when it's not running. I do have a very high-tech demonstration. I have a pencil and a shoelace. No expenses spared. No expenses spent. Anyway. So this little pencil here, that's the spindle, that's the metal point. And because it's got a rounded tip, as it rolls out, the roving, this shoelace, gets knocked. And as it gets knocked, it adds a little bit of a twist. So it's adding that twist, it's making our cotton stronger. Once it comes all the way to the front, it rolls it up just like that. It's a pretty clever machine, really. What I quite like about this one as well is it kind of shows us how hard life was in the mills. So I've got a copy of an engraving here. It shows us the team of people that would have been working on it. So in the middle, we've got the spinner, and if you wanted to be anyone in the mills, you would want to be the spinner. They're in fact paid the most to be there, and it's their job to make sure this machinery is running correctly. Now, they are paid lots, they've got to hire the people that work for them out of their own pocket. So if they're clever, if they want to keep their hands on that money, they're going to be hiring members of their own family. Someone like this person right here, our Pisa. So if you're a Pisa, chances are you're the spinner's wife, sister, or eldest daughter. And it's your job to repair any of these threads if they snap. So they can snap as the machine's running, and if they do, you've got to grab the loose end, follow the machine in, and as the machine's still running, stick your arm inside of it, grab the loose end, give it a little bit of a twist, hopefully repairing it. So that is an absolutely grueling job. In fact, we worked out you could be walking about 30 miles in one day, walking up and down, following them in and out. Bear in mind, that's before we have to go home and cook for your Victorian husband as well. There's one more person in this image, and I'll be really honest with you, this engraving, absolute nonsense. This is propaganda to make the mill owners look good, because they've made this person look like a grown-up. However, they've got a brush in their hands, they're doing a cleaning job. Who does the cleaning in the mills? The children, that's correct. And this poor child is doing by far the worst job in the mill. So they're known as a scavenger. If you're a scavenger, your job to sweep the floor of any cotton dust, any bits of broken thread as well, you'd have to collect it, put it in a little pouch, because it's still worth a little bit of money. Now, it doesn't sound too bad. However, you can't come in at the front here, well, this carriage is drawn back. So your piece is there, and you don't want to risk tripping her up. So that child would have to go round the back of the machine. As the carriage rolled forwards, in about 10 to 12 seconds, the dash in on hands and knees, sweep up, dash, back out, before that carriage came slamming back towards them. So it's such a dangerous job, no right-minded spinner would really want to hire their own child to do it. So instead, the mill owners, they went to orphanages, and they outright bought children to work for them. Sometimes through an apprenticeship working for literal pennies, but really more often than not, working for their training, their bed, that's the floor, and their dinner, a porridge or a potato. They're working up to 15 hours in one day. So those kids were known as the little slaves of Britain, and I'll be honest with you, can't really think of a better name for them. But well, once again, our miller is happy because he gets to make this, doesn't he? He gets to make his thread. So again, you could sew with it or you could weave with it as well. And we do have a weaving loom as well. So if you want to come on down just a little bit, and I'll show